was the one for me. Well, all right. It was a cold September before the Indian summer. That's the thing I remember when she gave.
Just a perfect day. Drink sangria in the park. And then later, when it gets dark, we go home. Just a perfect day. Feed animals in the zoo. Then later, a movie too, and then home. Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep. Just a perfect day. Problems all left alone. Weekenders on our own. It's such fun. Just a perfect day. You made me forget myself. I thought I was someone else, someone good.
Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep me hanging on.
You're going to reap just what you sow. Just watch your soul. You're going to reap just watch your soul. You're going to reap just watch your soul.
Well, your friends with their fancy persuasion don't admit that it's part of a scheme. And I can't help but have my suspicion, baby, 'cause I ain't quite as dumb as I seem. You said that you never intended to break up our scene in this way. Oh, there ain't any use pretending, baby, it could happen to us.
Rise. How you doing, Simon?
Thank you, Shirley.
This year?
Aye, same as every year, mate.
There's only one boy for the gala, Bonnie's gonna have to see. Maybe better taking photos in there.
Aye.
Hello.
Yeah. Champion Connor McCall to escort first maid Rachel Miller to the stage. Second champion, Ben Houghton, to escort second maid, Rachel Bailey, to the stage. Thank you.
like to call upon first champion Conor McCall to escort lady in waiting Emma Kelly to the stage. I'd now like to call upon second champion Ben Houghton to escort lady in waiting Demi Thompson to the stage. To call upon first champion Conor McCall to escort Queen-elect Amy Turner, followed by her ladies-in-waiting Abby Dougal and Sophie Ward to the stage. Second champion Ben Houghton to escort crowning lady Mrs. Jane Summers to the stage. First champion Conor McCall to bring up the crown and scepter, accompanied by second champion Ben Houghton, who will carry the royal proclamation. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I give you the 2016 Gala Court. I will now ask our honorary president, Mr. Bill Angus, to come up and say a few words, hopefully.
A warm welcome to everyone in this, our 105th gala. As you can see again, the court this year looks splendid, from Queen-elect Amy to our crowning lady Jane. Well done, parents and committee, and Chaz. Jane was for many years on the committee, as well as other committees in the village. She moved into Carstairs and has wholeheartedly become involved in the community. Why do I get older looking and she gets younger looking? Before the proceedings start, I have a very important tribute to make. John Forrest, our president, has been on the Gala Committee for 25 years. 24 and a half years of them as president. He's known locally as Bonnie. Not, I'm sad to say, because he was a Bonnie baby. But I'm sure he was, but for his liking for bonbons. After 6 months in the committee in the early 90s, he became president. Every single challenge he conquered as he headed the committee. Not only did he bring our gala into the 21st century, but he maintained the values set by our founders. A quote I heard recently sums this up. You can't do today without thinking of yesterday, and you can't do tomorrow without thinking of today. He changed the gala in four key areas. He ensured that all children of court age were involved. One year there were 24 children on this stage. He ensured that the gala was purely for children and families. He ensured that all adults, whether local or visitors, got a cup of tea, a pie and a cake on gala day, free of charge. He changed the programme by talking to the children to see what they wanted. He also made the gala as self-sufficient as possible by various means. Instead of getting wooden stalls and loan from Ravenstruther, he bought gazebos. Finally, he's got reliable ones. Instead of hiring a sound system, he bought our own, which could be used throughout the week. Instead of hiring bouncy castles, he bought our own and used them free of charge for the children. He also purchased generators. We used to get a van from Ferguson's, then Tufnell's. He hired one so that he could have it all week. When money was tight, he would have some very unusual fundraising events. He made Thursday night a fun night for children, and he promoted the need for a better procession. Over his time in office, only a few committee members have left, and most of them still take part in some way. He has built up a committee with many long-term members and welcomes any new members. We are desperately needing new members. Health and safety has played a major part in challenging his efforts, but as each problem arises, he solves it. We had to change the procession route some years ago after a serious accident. Every challenge, he finds a solution, as well as a plan B. Alas, he can't control the weather, but he's working on it. He can't, it's a luxury now to get a pipe band, but his plan B is he's got Scott, who's a very accomplished piper, on the committee. The annual dance was always a social occasion for committee, friends and parents of the court, and never made money. It's now a good fundraiser, and every year more and more attend. I was a neighbour of John for 25 years and feel very proud of what he has achieved in Carstairs. And when other galas have floundered, Carstairs has flourished, thanks to John and his committee. You don't need a calendar, as every year, the night before gala, John does the garden. When I asked the committee to sum up John in one word, the comments were enthusiastic, extraordinary, incredible, dedicated, passionate, homegrown, cool, late, solid, inspirational, optimistic, focused, forgetful, and determined. The usual phrase used by all committee is, "Where is Bonnie?" Some say that Jeanette, his wife, and the committee should get a medal, especially the treasurer and the secretary. When I asked what small gift he should get, the answers were an alarm clock, an up-to-date joke book, an all-year gardening book, a notebook, spare pair of glasses, and a box of bonbons. To give this small gift, I will invite our secretary Nanette to present John with the gift. Can you show your appreciation for John Forrest?
Need to say anything else because Bill said everything, but Bonnie, this is just a wee gift for you, for your 25 years of dedication, hard work, and we need a leader, so here's to the next 25. So could everybody please give three cheers for the Queen?
And finally, three cheers for all the good people, the Carstairs and district, and especially all the new people to the village and all our visitors today. Hip hip! By your words, it's been an honour as chairman of the Carstairs District Gala for 25 years. Yeah. It's been a pleasure. I wasn't expecting this, so I'm really stuck for words for once. But anyway, the gala day is not about me. It's kids that we've got in this court and our good crowning lady. So, a few words I would just like to say. I've got a vote of thanks. I need my glasses because it's my own writing. First of all, a big hand to the parents of the court for such an excellent turnout of the children. Secondly, to our gala day drivers who every year come along with our cars, beautifully turned out, and they go round with the kids. Thank you. To all the children and the parents of the fancy dress and the fancy dress parade, once again, absolutely fantastic. It takes a lot of effort and it's really appreciated. It makes our gala day that bit special. Our everyday helpers during gala week and of gala day itself, thank you. And of course, our judges this year were Mrs. Anne McFadgen and Mrs. Elma Cunningham. They were both teachers from Bigger. Unfortunately, they can't make the court ceremony, but they were here all day, and we've got the results, which we'll read out later on. And finally, a thanks to our small but very excellent and fantastic gala committee. Thank you. This week we've actually seen record attendances at all our events. We were 106 children turned up for the five-a-side football. We had about 60 children for the welly throwing, with 93 kids for our disco. The numbers, we were talking 600, 700 children over the week.
It gives me great pleasure to crown you, Amy,
Carstairs and District Gala Queen for 2016.
Connor shall now read the Royal Proclamation.
Whereas it is desirable that our loyal and faithful subjects should be acquainted with our royal mind on several divers and important matters which touch their happiness and welfare. Therefore, be it known that it is our royal command and pleasure that all the youths and maidens do live in charity and do constantly show goodwill to each other. That all our loyal subjects do at all times love truth and keep faith and obey the divine instructions to honour their fathers and mothers and also show due respect to teachers and other placed in authority over them. That they ever bear in the mind the poet's injunction that he prayeth best who loveth best all things both great and small, and do therefore ever show tender care and regard for the humbler forms of animal creation, and be it further known that any person found guilty of disobeying this proclamation will incur a royal displeasure and be liable to be excluded forthwith from the presence of our royal self and all our faithful subjects, given at Carstairs on the 25th day of June, in the year of our Lord, 2016, Amy Gala, Queen.
Well done, Connor. Jane shall now make her gift to the Queen. Ben shall now read the telegrams.
To Queen Amy, congratulations on your special day. Sorry I can't be with you to celebrate, but I'm thinking about you and sending my love and hugs from down under. Enjoy every minute. Love you loads from Auntie Davina and wee Jimmy. To Queen Amy and Court, hope you have a fantastic day from the Gala Committee. To Queen Amy, congratulations and good luck on being Carstairs Gala Queen 2016. All our love, kisses and cuddles always, Auntie Lisa, Uncle Jamie, Jack and Jess. To Amy, hope you have a lovely day. Lots of love. From Gran and Papa. To Amy, congratulations, Gala Queen. Stephen, Valerie, Erin, and me. To Queen Amy, hope your day is amazing. May the sun shine on you today and always. Lots of love, Graham. To Amy, congratulations and good luck on your big day. My beautiful little queen, a star in the making. Love you lots, have the best day. Lindsay, Darren and wee Walter. To Amy, hope the sun shines for you and your court. Lots of love and kisses. Auntie Diane and Uncle Crawford, Emma and Victoria. To to Queen Amy and her court. Hope you have a wonderful day from the crowning lady. To Queen Amy, hope your special day is as amazing as you are. Lots of love, Mum and Dad. Love you.
Well done, Ben. Abby will now present a bouquet of flowers to Jane. I now call upon Queen Amy to open this year's gala day.
It gives me great pleasure to declare open Carstairs and District Gala for 2016.
I now call upon everyone to be upstanding for the national anthem. Now, if anyone would like to take some photographs, we'll have a 5-minute session. Thank you.
Perfect.
Table.
What?
Table.
Where is it?
Get one of the commission.